Hello everyone, how are you feeling? How are you doing? What's going on? Welcome back or welcome. So today you want to see the update on the craft room and this DIY project that I have behind me. Now, I have never painted furniture before, but this is something that I felt was simple enough for me to be able to tackle. Yes, I ran into some hiccups along the way, but as you can see behind me, we are all finished. It is by no means perfect, but it is good enough for me and I am very proud of doing this project. So my parents recently moved and they had these two bookshelves and they did not want them in their new home. So I was like, me, can I have them? And they were gracious enough to let me have them. So I'm very appreciative. Thank you, mom and dad. So what I decided to do was I knew I wanted them white. I want all the furniture in here white. Although these bookshelves are strictly for storage. They are not for any decor items at all. As most people that you've probably seen when they paint their bookshelves, it's normally housed with some cute decor items. Unfortunately, this is just for storage for my bath and body business, True to Vibes Beauty. So as you can see, I have already gone ahead and stacked everything on there. And yeah, so I wanna just preface by saying I am, of course, in no way a professional. So if you are a professional or this is something that you've done multiple times, please leave some tips in the comments below for other viewers. We will greatly appreciate it. Now I wanna go through kind of the process on what I did to get these bookshelves the way that they are now. I will share everything that I used down in the description box below. Now, this, you know, I know nothing about the different types of wood at the moment. You know, there's always room to grow. There's always room to learn. But I knew this wasn't real wood, so I wanted to sand off the finish, the coating that was on there at the moment. And I did that at first by hand, and it didn't feel like it was enough. So I grabbed a sander and sanded down, which honestly, I don't know if it was enough or if it was just the material of the bookshelves themselves. The backing of the bookshelves is not any type of wood. It's like cardboard, so of course you can't sand that. So I had my most difficulty painting that area. But you can sand by hand, but it is very tedious, time consuming. I wouldn't recommend it, but it is doable. You just have to really put your time into it. So a hand sander, I feel like, would probably be quickest on the time consuming part. And I did do everything up here in the craft room. We don't have a garage. I didn't do it on the back patio or anything like that because I can't physically move these two up and down the stairs by myself. So I do have a sander that has an attachment that catches all of the dust, which is wonderful. So if you are a newbie like me and you haven't purchased a sander yet, I recommend getting a sander that has that attachment that will catch everything. So one of the bookshelves had cabinet doors and I went ahead and removed those because I want to be able to see everything at first glance. I don't want to have to open doors to see what inventory, what items that I have. I want to already like kind of have an idea without having to glance at a spreadsheet. You know what I'm saying? So I removed the doors and now the bookshelves are identical. I did make a mistake initially. So I remember how I said the backing was cardboard. So I was like, I don't need backing. I'll just have it see-through, you know, see through the wall. I removed it. That was a huge, huge mistake, because that is the structure integrity of the bookshelf. When I removed that, the bookshelf was swaying from side to side like a tree in a breeze. It was horrible, so I ended up nailing it back on there. So for any of you, do not do it if it is like these bookshelves behind me. After everything was nailed back on, sanded, I went ahead and painted. I didn't cover any of the holes, you will see, because I didn't really mind having the holes there because it is really for storage, kind of aesthetic purposes because I painted it white, but for the most part, it is for functionality. So I left the holes there and I did do two coats on the bookshelves. I did not paint underneath the shelves. I only painted what you really can see. Like nobody's gonna be up under the bookshelf like this. And if you are, then you nosy and that's not my problem, okay? Anyways, so yeah, it took me two coats, about, I'll say on average, 4 days to complete, with working, still doing stuff for the house, tending to the dogs, and you know, just everyday life things. So without further ado, here is the before, here is the after, and here is the after after. I hope I'm not forgetting anything. Yeah, I just wanted to keep this quick and light. Just make sure that you are sanding your bookshelves before you paint. I used a satin paint that was a paint and primer combo. Maybe you can try just doing a primer and then a paint instead of that combo mix, because I'm guarantee at some point down the line, the paint will scratch up on this. But it's a quick fix, so I'm okay with it for now until, you know, I go ahead and decide, hey, I'm in a better financial situation where I can just go buy the nice bookshelves already white that I want. But until then, you know, we're DIYing, we are learning, we are growing. We are making our house into a home, one project at a time. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.